Hi, I'm Dr. Rajani, talking today about fake Botox. I get asked this a lot, especially when I go around the country, do trainings, and people say, well, we think there's fake Botox in our town and cheap Botox. And we did an Instagram post on this, and one of the top questions was, how do I know if I'm getting fake product? Well, there's a lot of nuances around product, effective product, fake product, and ways that you can maybe tell and ways that you think you can but can't. We'll go through that here today in this video. There's three types of Botox here. Botox is a brand name, but we have Xeomin and Dysport as well. And there's really three types, in my opinion, of fake Botox. There's imported product. Now that product might come from Canada, it might come from another country, but the product was made by the manufacturer. So maybe it's not really fake, but you really can't import from other countries. And the biggest problem with that is handling. How do you know how it was stored? Because the two of the three need to be kept cold, and if they're not, the end product won't work as well. So there's imported. The next is what I call real fake product. The writing on the vial is in a different language. You don't know where it was manufactured. It was probably made by a third party, and it might look nothing like normal product. And the third product is, and I don't see this anymore here, but it's animal derived product. And there are cases of people using this mainly in the early 2000s. The product there was a lot of variability, of course, and the unit dosing, if it's off a little bit, then it will be either not effective at all or too effective. And too effective, of course, is a bigger problem. So those are, when I think about it, those are really the three types of fake product that you can get. People and practitioners had great ideas on how to tell if it's fake, because as a consumer, that's what you might want to know. So the one thing that Allergan has done is, and the other companies, have put a hologram on the vial. So if you see a hologram on the vial, but then you need to look at the vial, and if you can recreate a $100 bill, you can recreate a hologram on a vial, and it could be a legitimate vial with another product in. So how can you really tell that the product in that vial is the product that was originally mixed in there? So while it's something good to see, it's not 100% foolproof. The second way, and this is a reasonable way, is to look up on the physician locator for the product for the company. And if the person's not on the locator, maybe they're not ordering from within this country. The problem there is you don't have to place all of your order of product from this country. You could be getting a mix of product, so you don't necessarily know, and they're still on the locator. So the consensus was from the Instagram, well, it's another step that you can take, but it's certainly not foolproof to know. The third way was to have it drawn up in front of you. Many people said that, well, you could have the product drawn up in front of you, see where it's coming from, maybe it's mixed up in front of you, but again, you don't particularly know where that vial came from. And if it's imported from another country, really, it looks very, very similar. I'm Canadian, and the Carruthers, who invented Botox, are from Vancouver, and really a lot of it started up there. But the vials look the same when you get them. If I see them individually, I can't particularly tell the difference. And of course, they have the hologram up there, so you could get it mixed up in front of you. But again, not a foolproof way. So those are three things that were suggested. They're not foolproof, but collectively together can probably help you. Other things like if it works or if it worked before but it doesn't work now, dilutions and storage and all those things I go through in other videos, but really the patient cares about the result. The number one thing to ask when you call a clinic really is who's doing it, how long they've been doing it, their experience, and you can ask about their product. So do your due diligence, find the clinic. Still, the best way is word of mouth through people you know have been going to somewhere for a while. Let us know below what's your method to make sure that you're getting what you pay for and you feel comfortable at the clinic you're going to. Subscribe to this channel. Keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.